morning, everybody. Welcome to another Jubilant Saturday, May 28, 2022. May's just kicking right, almost at the end of May already. This month has sure gone by fast. Today is episode 733, part 1, your Days of Praise passage. It is the next installment of the video series with number 81, the builder of the house. Beginning with Hebrews 3, verses 3 and 4, and compiled from John D. Morris. So if you're excited about another Jubilant Saturday, smash that like button. Comment, you know somebody that builds houses. Let me know. Is it a friend, family member, or close, a former colleague from your, wherever you're working at? Who in your life has built a house? Could be a family member, could be a close-knit friend. Let me know. What's their company? Because I'll look them up and see what. I just would like to look up the company and see how well the company is. Just to put a good word in on somebody. If I could put a comment on their webpage and say, oh, so-and-so mentioned you in a comment on my YouTube video. Just wanted to say, keep up the good work and build those houses. Or something along that, some little good comment for that person. So let me know. So subscribe if you do, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me get above 10 subscribers. Get me up above 10 so it'll quit bouncing between 9 and 10. Get me to the double digit mark. By Tuesday, I will be much, much appreciated if you'll help me do that. So, too much to talk. It's too long to explain what I'm trying to get at. So, but number 81, the builder of the house. Number 81 of the video series. Today we're going to start with Hebrews chapter 3, verses 3 and 4, from John D. Morris. The verse says, "He who hath builded the house hath more honor than the house. For every house is builded by some man, but he that built all things is God." Amen. So perhaps the single greatest category of evidence for supernatural creation is in the nature of the creation itself, which everywhere shows such intricate design that it could not have come about by random chance. Consider the earth, its size, mass, distance from the sun and moon, rotational wobble, chemical makeup, etc., are critical within very narrow limits. So any significant deviation in any of these or other characteristics would make life impossible. So both inorganic molecules, planets, and galaxies are simpler by several orders of magnitude than even the tiniest living organism. So the marvelous genetic code that regulates life, growth, and reproduction is so unthinkably complex, so obviously designed, that it would take a willingly ignorant 2 Peter 3:5 mind to conclude a naturalistic origin for it. And life at every stage and at every level of investigation shows symmetry in its order, purpose in its function, and interdependence between its parts. All of these are clear marks of design by an intelligent designer. Amen? So the evidence speaks so eloquently that even the invisible things of Him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even His eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse. Romans 1:20. If they choose not to believe and therefore merit and face His wrath. Verse 18. So all things were created by Him and for Him. Colossians 1:16. And mankind can take no pride in it, nor rebellious solace in the idea of naturalistic origin. For Thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power for those. For Thou hast created all things, and for Thy pleasure they are and were created. Revelation 4:11. So you see, this place we call, that we actually we call home right now, is a house created by the divine builder Himself, our loving Creator, God. Amen. Thought I have for you today. Coming up tomorrow in your Sunday, your glorious Lord's Day Sunday, May 29th, 2022, episode 734, part 1, we're going to be talking about hereby, we'll be learning about hereby know. Beginning with 1 John 4:13, and this time it is from Henry M. Morse. From the original Henry M. Morse. From the original Morse. So. Stay tuned to that. I'll get to that sometime later tonight, but you'll see that one tomorrow morning. Coming up at 5:45 today, which no turning point today. So coming up at 5:45 for your evening video, your Daily Bread passage, episode 733, part 2. For your Jubilant Saturday, May 28, 2022, we're going to be talking about the Narrow Door Cafe. From Po Fang Chia, P-O-H-F-A-N-G. C-H-I-A, like Chia Pet, Chia. Oh, sorry for my voice cracking on that one. Usually don't crack when I say that. Chia. See? It's kind of cracking the first time, but. But it is all derived from Luke 13, 22 to 30. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that later this evening. After 5:45. So with that said, I'm not going to try to ramble anymore, make this video either longer. But until later, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe and all you say and do in 2022. And until later, peace out, everybody. Goodbye, God bless, have a wonderful rest of your Jubilant Saturday morning and afternoon. Come back after 5:45 where we will be visiting the Narrow Door Cafe. Should be a good one. But until then, goodbye.